Hello, my big brother, I'm Halloween. In today's video, you are gonna know how to use the ChipScope of the ILA to debug the FPGA circuit board. Firstly, create an ILA file. Right-click the project and select New Source. Click ChipScope Definition and Connection File and input a name. We can find a file that ends with .cdc is generated. Double-click it and a wizard will pop up. In the device and icon tabs, we leave them default. In the ILA tab, we aim to capture data out and data out flag as examples. In the trigger parameters, data out is 8-bit and data out flag is 1-bit. Thus, we set the trigger width is 9-bit. In the capture parameters, we set the depth to 2048. That means we will sample 2048 times for this 9-bit data. Here we select data same as trigger. That means this 9-bit data will be both as a trigger condition and as data we aim to capture. In the net condition tab, a new window will pop up after double clicking any branch. In the clock signals tab, use asterisk and keywords to search target variables. Assign our global clock as its target clock. One more thing we need to be aware. The clock pin cannot be assigned. We must assign clock buffer group to make sure it can work. Click the Make Conditions button to assign buffer group to the channel. In the trigger data signals, assign data out and data out flag to the channel. We can click the headline to directly assign multiple variables into the channel in ascending order. Click OK to close this window. Click Return to Project Navigator to close the ChipScope wizard. Click the top UART module and then double-click Analyze Design using ChipScope. Click the icon in the top left to establish the connection between ChipScope and FPGA circuit board. Right-click the FPGA circuit board icon and click Config to import the configuration information into the circuit. Double-click Trigger Setup to set the trigger condition. Normally, we use binary in the Randex option so that we can conveniently set the value. Here, R is the rising edge, F is the falling edge, 1 is the high level, and 0 is low level triggering. The type we select is window. Windows we set it to 1, meaning it will only capture one time. Depth we set 2048. This matches the previous depth setting in the ChipScope wizard. 2048 is the maximum value. We also can set a smaller value. The position we set it to 100. This means it will first capture 100 times before matching the triggering condition. Double-click the waveform branch to pop up the waveform window. We can find the target variables have been in it. If it is empty, we also can right-click the variable in the left navigator. Select End to View and then select Waveform to add the variable manually. Now, let's apply Setting and Arm Trigger. We can see the hint in the bottom of the Trigger Setup window. Let's move on to the Serial Port tool and send 8-bit data such as AA to the circuit. After the data is sent, we can find the capture stopped. In the waveform, the previous value is 55, and when the data out flag is set, the value is set to AA. We can click the magnifying glass icon to zoom in or zoom out the waveform. We can also box select the target zoom to magnify the specific area. Now, let's capture multiple triggering points. Set the window to 16, which means we will sample 16 triggering points. Depth is set to 128. The reason is the top depth 2048 needs to be allocated to 16 triggering points. Now, let's send the 16 8-bit data to verify. In the waveform, we can find we have captured these 16 trigger points. That's all for today's video.